Hi, what is arteriovenous malformations or AVM? Will they bleed and will they cause epilepsy? And what are the best ways to make the diagnosis and treatment of these AVMs? Hi, this is your neurologist, Dr. Omar Danoun. AVMs, there are bad and good news. The bad news is that this is the most dangerous malformations of the arteries in the brain, and it has risk of rupture and complications. And the good news is that we have much better understanding of these AVMs, and there are a lot of new technologies that are deployed now for safer and more successful treatment of this condition. Normally, the blood flow goes from the arteries, which usually have a strong wall and high pressure, and then it will narrow down into the small blood vessels called capillaries, and then the flow will slow there, will give nutrients, will give oxygen and nutrients to the cells, and then slowly will drain back to the veins, which usually have a bigger caliber and a smaller and thinner wall, but the pressure there is very small, so it's not a problem, and it drains back to the heart. In the case of AVM, there is a direct connection between the artery, the arterio, and the veins, venous malformation. So there will be a connection directly from the artery, which has very high pressure, all the way directly to the veins, which have a thinner wall and low pressure. So those veins will be exposed to very high pressure all at once without this transient, and this will cause risk of bleeding and rupturing of those blood vessels, and sometimes it will cause some leaking of the blood, so it can cause irritation to the brain, which might lead to epilepsy. Luckily, AVMs are rare to happen and occurs only 1 in 1,000 people, so if you have AVM, you are the lucky one. What causes AVM to happen? The exact cause of AVM is not understood well. We do not find any exact cause or correlation. There is no genetic abnormalities or any other tendencies, except in very rare cases of familiar genetic conditions that have AVM in them. So most of the time, it's just the formation of the brain, how the brain formed in the womb. That's where those connections are made. How do AVMs present? The presentation of AVM depends so much on the location and the size of those AVMs. Sometimes it can be unnoticed, silent, growing in the head and the brain for many years without you noticing, and sometimes they can rupture, means burst those, and cause bleeding, which can lead to a stroke, which will present in a sudden headache, weakness in one side, inability to speak or talk, or other symptoms depending where the location of the AVM was. And sometimes with this slow leaking of blood from the AVM, it can cause irritation to the surrounding brain, which can lead to electricity and excitation of the cells, which leads to seizures and epilepsy. And in some cases, it can be silent. Headache, by the way, is an extreme rare presentation of AVMs. I know that sometimes every brain malformation, brain tumor, or anything, like, you would think that headache is the most common presentation. No, it is not. It is very rare to have headache in AVM unless there is a complication. And sometimes those AVMs will grow and disturb the brain function. If like we have very large AVMs, so the brain will not be able to work correctly or be deprived from oxygen nutrients because of the shunting of all the blood, and we can have speech issues, weakness in one side of the body, depends where the location of the AVM is. And sometimes AVMs are completely silent and we only discover them when we do a scan for an unrelated issue and we find those AVMs. How do we make the diagnosis of AVM? The diagnosis of AVM is made by doing brain imaging and looking at those arteries and the brain structure. We usually get a brain MRI scan with contrast, or a head CT scan with contrast, and the contrast is a dye that will light up those abnormal cells and abnormal malformations of the arteries and veins, so those scans can be helpful. And sometimes we can do a formal angiogram. So angiogram is a brain catheterization, which we will put a small puncture wound in the groin, go into the artery, and then thread the wires all the way to the brain, and then inject the dye in the arteries, and that will give us the map of all the arteries and the veins in the brain, and we will be able to see those AVMs, and most importantly, we'll be able to see the feeding artery, where the nidus or the origin of this malformation is, which can help a lot to plan the treatment in the future. This is an example of an angiogram. Look at this. This is the normal angiogram. It will shine all the arteries and then it will drain into the veins. And on the other side, this is an abnormal angiogram. Look at this. Like, will inject the dye, there is a nidus of the AVM, and this is where the abnormal malformation, look at this like thick dark area where the AVM is, and it drains back. So this is an angiogram in AVM. If you have AVM, there is no need to screen your family for AVMs like we do sometimes in aneurysms of the brain. This is different, and it only runs in families in very rare occasion of called hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasias, and it has other vascular malformations in the body as well. How do we treat AVM? The treatment of AVM is very individualized, and it needs skilled neurosurgeons and vascular neurologists so that they can plan the treatment accordingly. However, in cases of AVM that are incidentally discovered on scans without any obvious complications, we anticipate the rates of bleeding between 2-3% a year. So the rate of bleeding and complications is small, and it tends to decrease over time. And another point, that pregnancy does not increase the chances of AVM rupturing. So if you have AVM and you get pregnant, you will not have higher risk of bleeding as others might think. If the AVM ruptures and causes bleeding, then we have to intervene by surgical treatment right away. There are two types of surgery, depends on the experience of the surgeon and how the AVM presents. The first one is to just go inside and ligate and stitch those arteries and close the AVM, but man, AVMs are very bloody procedure. There is like lots of blood coming in because it's very high pressure arteries and veins, and it is likely that it will bleed a lot. So some surgeons tend to give coagulation factors and like clogging those by doing angiograms and putting a clogging material that we can use now to clog those feeding and high pressure arteries, to kind of like clog those pipes before, so that when we enter the surgery, we have a less bloody field, if you would say. And those techniques of angiograms and clogging materials are coming very fast, and lots of new materials and new technologies coming to this field. So it's an exciting time for treatment of AVMs. And the other thing, if AVMs are causing epilepsy and seizures, which can happen a lot in patients with like seeding blood and irritating the brain, then we treat with anti-seizure medications so that we can prevent those seizures from happening. And in about the third of the cases, seizures might be resistant to treatment and medications will not work, and we call this drug-resistant epilepsy. And this type of epilepsy, we need to do surgical treatment to take out that scar in the brain or the AVM or anything, and where there are other new technologies that we can do to treat drug-resistant epilepsy by implanting devices in the neck and the brain. And I will show all of these devices and all of the different surgical treatments and the laser treatment for surgery in this video for all the comprehensive details. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.